Hi, welcome back NPV News Channel. Harry and Meghan Markle were spotted together for the first time since Meghxit as they stepped off a plane in Canada on Valentine's Day. Pictures showed the royal couple were all smiles carrying their own bags as they landed in Canada minus baby Archie after taking a flight from the US. They touched down at Victoria Airport at around 4:45 p.m. Friday, with what appeared to be a small group of security. The couple chose to take a commercial flight this time, having previously been slammed for preaching about saving the planet, and then flying around the world by private jet. Meghan went one step further with an outfit that was all about sustainable fashion, wearing shoes made with recycled plastic water bottles and using a carry-on bag made from a material that can allegedly be recycled indefinitely. The Duchess, who led the way out of the plane with her husband following closely behind, was wearing a striped shirt, black cardigan, jeans and black pumps, and her hair was loose around her neck. She was carrying a bag over her shoulder with a bulky gray sweater tucked into the strap and clutching a Prada duffel bag. Her $125 black pumps, a break from her signature heel, are from Rothy's, a San Francisco-based company that makes its shoes from repurposed water bottles destined for landfill. Normally a stiletto devotee, Meghan's favorite brands include Stuart Weitzman and Aquasura, and she's rarely seen in anything lower than a 4-inch heel. Meghan went one step further with an outfit that was all about sustainable fashion, wearing shoes made with recycled plastic water bottles and using a carry-on bag made from a material that can allegedly be recycled indefinitely. When the couple first announced their plans to step back from senior royal life, they made mention of their plans to launch a new charity, writing on their website that their decision to split their time between North America and the UK would help them in this endeavor. Meghan Markle could one day be US president, according to punters, after the Duke and Duchess of Sussex quit royal duties. Markle is over the age of 35. A resident of the United States for at least 14 years and a natural-born citizen. That's more than we can say about either foreign-born John McCain or Ted Cruz. President Obama's birth was also questioned, of course. His birth certificate was demanded by a successor, someone rumored to have been born on another planet. This isn't the first time that Meghan has been predicted to run for the presidency in the near future. Last month, crisis management expert Mark Borkowski said that it is not unlikely for Markle to venture into an entirely different field. Meghan is 66/1 with Cole to become US president by 2033. The bookmaker said that a string of bets had been placed on the American-born former actress, 38, following in the footsteps of the likes of Barack Obama and Donald Trump. Coral spokesman Harry Aitken had said, "We take such a wide variety of bets from punters who think they can predict the future, but the one that stands out at the moment is Meghan Markle to become president by 2033. Punters clearly fancy her chances of running for office, and at 66-1 we certainly think stranger things have happened." Meghan and Prince Harry are close friends with Mr. Obama, who was US president from 2009 to 2017. Meanwhile, the ex-suit star has previously called Mr. Trump divisive and misogynistic. Throwing her weight behind his rival Hillary Clinton in an appearance on The Nightly Show with Larry Wilmore in 2016. Meghan added, "You're not just voting for a woman if it's Hillary. Yes, you're voting because she's a woman, but certainly because Trump has made it easy to see that you don't really want that kind of world that he's painting." It comes as the Sussexes are walking away from the monarchy and setting up home in Canada. They reveal plans to step back as senior royals in a bombshell statement in January. The couple will drop their HR8 styles in exchange for financial freedom. Meghan and Harry had hoped for a dual role, supporting the Queen, the Commonwealth and Harry's military associations, but the idea was deemed unworkable. They are currently staying in a £10 million mansion on Vancouver Island with their son Archie. Friends have claimed that Meghan and Harry plan to move to the US in the future, but not while Mr. Trump is in charge. A source told the Daily Mail last month, "It's by no means an immediate thing, but there is a long-term plan to end up back in the US with a second home in Canada, where they will also spend a great deal of time." The couple used the words North America in their statement about where they plan to live deliberately. It doesn't pin them down to any one place. Last week, the Sussexes attended their first event since announcing they were leaving royal life behind. Harry gave a speech at a J.P. Morgan-sponsored alternative investment summit in Florida. It is not known if he was paid for the appearance at the exclusive event, but it was speculated he could have pocketed hundreds of thousands of pounds. Meghan and Harry are officially due to start their new life away from the monarchy in the spring. Royal watchers will be waiting to see if the Sussexes, who are president and vice president of the Queen's Commonwealth Trust, will join the royal family at Westminster Abbey in London on March 9 for the annual Commonwealth Day service. It emerged yesterday that they are closing their Buckingham Palace office, with up to 15 members of staff losing their jobs. So far, the Queen has been the only member of the royal family to release an official statement about Harry and Meghan's departure. Her Majesty said, "Harry, Meghan, and Archie will always be much loved members of my family. I recognize the challenges they have experienced as a result of intense scrutiny over the last 2 years and support their wish for a more independent life." Thank you for watching videos. If you like our video, please subscribe our channel and ring the bell to receive notifications of latest videos.